Include is one of those concepts you learn now and then you use it on a daily basis. So let's see what include is about. Okay, let's start by creating a new folder into src include. And inside this one, let's create a new file include folder PUG files.pug, and then let's go over here and drag include over here, close that one, and also close readme file for the moment. So let's create two more files. One would be header.pug and one would be footer.pug. And now let's type some code in here. So as far as you can see, we've typed some code in here, and this one generated this HTML. So now let's move some of this code. Let's move this head into header. Well, actually, let's rename that header into head. Rename. And paste it in here. Save it. And now if we also save this one, we can see that we no longer have a head. So let's fix that and say include head. So now the head is back. Now let's remove, actually cut this footer, paste over here, shift up a couple of times. Let's also rearrange this for a second. And now if we save this one, you can see that the footer has disappeared. However, if we are to put it back, we can say include footer, and the footer will be back in place. Now this footer over here, it's the name of this file, so it's this footer over here, and this head over here, it's the name of this file head. So this is how they link together. Now let's quickly commit this. Stage allow changes include in QG and sync it. So this was include, where we used it to include other PUG files. Now let's see in the next lesson if we can include other type of files. So happy hacking!